Hey there, are HR issues giving you a frown? Turn it around with SmartHR. We are renowned.
Products are expensive, there's market instability. Here, everything is just off the roof. It's a lot, you ask me, honestly.
Entrepreneurs, lend us your ear. We're here to solve your HR problems crystal clear. From hiring to policies, we've got you covered.
So there are many efficient ways that helps you to still remain ethical and still serve your clients with the intention of the brand.
Tune in, discover the HR world anew. With SmartHR, success is within view. Entrepreneurs, gather near and far. Let's conquer HR challenges, no matter how bizarre.
Welcome to SmartHR, the podcast that unravels the intricacies of human resources and the world of resourceful entrepreneurs. I am your host, Chukwunonso Modi, and in today's episode, we delve into the challenges faced by entrepreneurs navigating the treacherous waters of limited funds and unpredictable supplier delays. Now, as the heartbeat of small businesses, these issues not only impact the bottom line, but they also have a direct effect on the quality of products and, of course, the satisfaction of clients. Now, join us as we explore the strategies, insights, and HR solutions that can help entrepreneurs weather these storms and, of course, emerge stronger on the other side. Trust me, it's a tale of resilience, adaptability, and invaluable role HR plays in the success of these determined visionaries. Let's hear from our entrepreneur of the day first, and then we'll also hear from our HR expert. We have Clement on the show. What exactly is his problem and in what ways can we help him solve it? Welcome, Clement. It's a pleasure to have you here.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you very much for having me.
Okay.
I'm very happy to be on the program.
Happy to have you here. So please, Clement, talk to us about yourself, your brand. What's the problem here?
Okay. My name is Clement Ijebia.
Okay.
I'm the creative director of Clemcalf Collections. Clemcalf Collections is a footwear and leather accessory brand located here in Lagos. I'm world of him precisely. I'm having some challenges.
Okay.
Concerning that is my business, that I want to ask some few questions.
Okay.
To get some
solution.
Answers or solutions, thank you. So actually, in this my business, we have challenges in terms of getting the products in the market and bringing it here, because sometimes when a customer order for a product, they have to go to the market and get them. So most times when you get there, you don't get what they ordered again. Maybe because it's no more in the market or things like that. So I want to know, apart from funding, because now it's not been long we've been doing this business.
Okay.
So we don't buy everything at once, you understand?
Mm.
We buy as we see in the market, then maybe when we get another order, we go to the market again and get. Most times, because of the timing, maybe the customer has given us, we have given the customer a date to meet up. But since we go to the market now, we find out that we didn't see those products again. So most times, they just decline the product. They say, that is what I want. And that is one of the places that we're having challenges with, because we have to now do refund, or we start talking, go back and forth.
Okay.
Since we've already collected the money for the business already, you know, delivering it is the problem now, because we've gone to the market and we didn't get what we wanted.
All right. So, Clement, to understand you better, you're saying that you have issues with your supply chain, like the suppliers now, getting them to give you the materials you need to make these items that you're to send to your clients, right?
Yes,
and because of limited funding now, it's just a startup, so you're trying your best to get suppliers that are still within that budget, your budget, right?
Yes, exactly.
Okay. All right. I would always say that this is the right place. It's called Smart HR for a reason. And of course, we have our HR expert that will answer these questions. I can understand how tough that can get. And I know how this will affect productivity as well, because you said it's also affecting your clients, you know, the delay from suppliers. Before you know it, the time for the timeline the clients have given you have passed. So, of course, nobody wants a brand that would delay, no matter how quality or, you know, how good it might be, except if you've established a relationship over time with them. But yeah, our HR experts would definitely give you solutions to the issue at hand. Thank you again, Clement, for coming on the show.
Thank you very much.
All right, we've heard from my entrepreneur, and of course, on the show, we don't just hear from them and, you know, just listen and let it pass. We always have our HR expert to give them a sense of direction on what else to do, what next, what should they stop, what else should they continue. We'll meet this special person after the break. Do not go anywhere. All right, welcome back to Smart HR, and it is that time of the show where we meet our HR expert. Of course, we've heard from entrepreneur, and now it's time to give him solutions. Our HR expert has been here before and is one person with a whole lot of knowledge. In fact, you know when they say somebody doesn't talk too much, but then she has so much to offer. She is Esther Luke, partner at Updrive Talent. Welcome back to the studio, Esther. It's a pleasure to have you here once again.
Thank you. I'm actually very happy to be here again.
Okay. Now, I've listened to Clement, and my first question for you, because I tried to get him to, you know, explain further. Would you say this is a limited funding issue, or is there more to it?
I wouldn't ascribe this to funding.
Okay.
No, I wouldn't. I would ascribe this to staying up to date and creating meaningful partnerships.
Okay.
Yes.
Creating meaningful partnership and staying up to date. All right.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Okay. So, what is your solution for him now? Because he has said this is a startup. He's just starting. It's a baby business for now. And he's having issues with his suppliers, which is now affecting clients, you know, the delay from their end. So what should he do in this case?
Okay. Since this is not a funding problem, like I said, I would say that he needs to have his already existing partners.
Okay.
When I mean partners, people that actually have the raw materials.
Okay.
That he requires. You have to form partnerships at all levels. So if he knows that he's not the guy with the raw materials, he needs those people to always execute his own part of the deal.
Mm.
And he's already putting out this, showcasing this stock out there, that this is what he's doing. And people would always come, oh, this is what you do, I want this.
Mm-hmm.
But he knows he doesn't have the raw materials, he has to go back.
Mm.
So like I said, meaningful partnerships with the people who have the raw materials. And staying up to this, these two work hand in hand.
Mm-hmm.
So for, let me say he's, for instance, let me just say it's Ankara that he needs. And he has this out there. And someone is making an order for it. Before that order is made, you can have a situation where every week you check in with your partners to be sure that this is still available. Uh-huh. Since you do not have the large funding to buy in bulk.
Mm-hmm.
You can always check in on a weekly basis, have a day that you update. And even if you're not updating, I feel like if you have a platform, you can always mean it there that this is currently out of stock.
Okay.
You don't have anybody placing orders on items that are already out of stock. So, like I said, and sometimes nothing is actually really exhausted in the market.
Mm-hmm.
But if you're able to create meaningful partnerships, what they tell you is not available can be available to others because they already have partnerships with these people. So when you have partnership, you have access to more things than the normal person who is strolling into the market that wants to buy. That's why sometimes you go to the market and they tell you that, oh, it's not available, but you're seeing it. But because someone else who was smart enough to have make that move already might not be there to collect it, but he has its result for him. Sometimes even before payments, because there was a meaningful relationship or partnership before that.
Yeah, before that. Yeah, yes. I do understand what you mean by meaningful. Like, he himself needs to keep stock so that he doesn't get caught off guard when clients are there. But now, this is an issue with outsourcing, and it's also affecting his clients. So can you give maybe ways in which he can communicate with them? Because he said too that because there's delay in sourcing material, he's losing clients. And, you know, this is just he's a recent business, and he needs clients that will stay and will help him to build his brand. And of course, he needs to do quality as well. So is there any way he can also try to maintain this relationship with the clients as well? I mean, I'm not saying that they have to stay. I mean, if it's not benefiting them, go to somewhere that will benefit you, but just for his sake. Or maybe there's a delay, maybe a means of communicating effectively so they understand and he doesn't have to lose too much clients.
Okay. One thing I noted from his question was that he was talking about having their funds and having to refund.
Okay,
should it
yes.
not be available.
Mm.
So there's some strategies that some businesses, they have a period where you can place order
okay.
on a particular item.
Mm.
He could as well put that out there. It's a business strategy. Oh, this is the time to place order for these particular items. Place your orders now. And you can also have a situation where he doesn't really need to have your money, but you can place an order and confirm after 24 hours.
Okay.
48 hours.
Mm.
Those things can happen. In that scenario, you do not have to have their money, but they are waiting for a confirmation for that to happen, for the process of money collection to happen.
Mm.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. So please take us through building contingency plan now, because I know you've mentioned it, but just specifics. So specifically, not just him, but other entrepreneurs, because I also find that some of them, I don't know, it may be because they feel like, oh, this person is, another thing is friendship again. Oh, he's my friend, so let me just stay with him. But meanwhile, that is killing your business. So in his case now, or in the case of others too, when you see that this supplier that you're outsourcing is not giving you the best, what other options should you have on ground so that you don't get to bear the brunt?
In my former life, I used to be a procurement person.
Okay.
So,
your former life.
I'm still very good at sourcing though. Okay. But then I would say that one thing you do, never just stick to one person.
Okay.
It's normal. Mm. You can decide to have partnerships with 10 people, but you know that one person is who you buy from.
Mm-hmm.
But that 10 people, they are your contingency plan.
Yes.
Should this happen, you know the next person to follow. But never stick to one person. And sometimes, don't even make bulk orders if you're trying to order for one person sometimes too, just in case they fail.
Mm.
You could actually make from two different people.
Okay.
One can come in before the other.
Mm-hmm.
But it doesn't mean that the other company, you don't longer need the resources. You need the resources, but at least you can attend to others firsthand when the second comes in.
Mm.
So I'll just say, don't stick to one person. It has never paid. Any business owner cannot stick to one person and succeed. You just have to have more people to
have more than one.
Yes.
Okay, before we end this episode, let's just talk about the funding, because he mentioned it, so I feel like it's something we should still touch on. I mean, I know he said limited funding, but would you say that, are there ways in which he can, you know, still do his best even with that limited funding that he has? Maybe ways in which he can still go around it, knowing that he doesn't have much money, because some people might say, oh, things are expensive in the market. And you know, you did mention that he might not necessarily have to collect money at first, that 24 hours this thing, but maybe he does need the money to be able to source the goods, that kind of thing. So what would you say as regards that?
It still goes to partnership, if you ask me. Okay. There are some businesses that run on raw materials not paid for. But the other end knows that once this is converted, we get our money.
Okay.
It's still partnership. Mm-hmm. I can decide that I'm a tailor and I want to sew. But let me not even use that example. Let me use... I'll just go back to my family a bit.
Okay.
My mom runs a poultry.
Okay.
And she already knows who is buying her birds. even before they mature. With or without that money, the other person knows that we already have an existing partnership. The bets always go to the person at a particular date, and there's a period for payment. Sometimes it will be that, oh, once I'm done selling this stock, you get all your money. And because you want to have some a ready-made buyer, you want to go into that kind of partnership. So I think it still boils down to partnership. If you create a partnership of trust anyway, nobody wants to give you their raw materials. So you should have built a form of like
relationship.
And even come up with payment plans. So that's where payment plan comes in. So you have that term to the person, but then you still have access to this material. So you might not have money, but you have those raw materials available. And in a situation where your raw materials are still not going, the other guy might be selling and be out of it and still want to sell more. And if you still have it, you can decide to even sell from what you have. It depends on whatever you built.
That's a very valid point. Once again, you have blown us away, Esther, with your knowledge. So thank you so much for coming on the show again.
Thank you for having me once again.
All right. Thank you too for tuning in. I hope you found this discussion very, very insightful. As I always say, please leave us a review. Share your feedback on our social media handles, Facebook, Instagram at Africa Business Radio, and on Twitter, Africa Biz Radio. We'd love to hear from you. Until next time, I am Chukwunonso Modi. Bye.
This podcast was proudly brought to you by ACT Foundation.